Very good morning to all. This is Dr. Ansar Ahmed, and in today's lecture, I'm going to talk about the role of birth and death process in telecom traffic. We already know what is birth and death process and why we use it. Okay, so let me recall the concept of birth and death process. BD processes are very useful in the analysis of telecom networks. So it birth and death process are useful in analysis of telecom network. Why? Because network can be modeled as a BD process, where the number of busy server represent the population. Okay, because telecom traffic is all about the occupancy or vacancy of servers. A call request means a birth in the network, and call termination means a death in telecom traffic. Okay. Analysis of BD process assumption. These are some assumptions. Without these assumptions, we cannot make the BD process assumption. This is very important. We have to assume. Because without assumption, we cannot make the actual analysis of BD process, because it will go beyond the condition. So some assumptions are important to discuss. Choose a time interval delta small enough such that. So very important, we are assuming a time interval delta so small enough such that there can almost be only one state transition that environment. So we are choosing delta so small that only one transition may be possible in that small time, only one arrival or one termination, but not both. So only one arrival of the call or termination may be possible. We are taking so much small time, and both may not be happen. I mean, in that, this is just like in delta time, there may be birth or death, not both. So we are considering so small, very very small. Just you can imagine how much small that is. If someone is arriving in the network, no, then that duration, no termination call be there, no arrival or termination leaving the state and change in the time interval delta. Or third condition is no arrival or termination leaving the state and change in the time interval. Okay. The probability of an arrival or termination in a particular interval is independent of what happened in the earlier time interval. So this probability of arrival or termination may be assumed as that it is free from, or it is independent of what happened in the earlier time interval, that is delta minus 1 or 1 minus delta. The probability of an arrival is directly proportional to the time interval delta. So whatever is happening, it is happening in the delta time. It is directly probability is directly proportional to delta time only. It is the happening time, we can say. Dynamic model of switching system as a birth death process. So this is very important, and this model just help to design the telecom traffic. Let PKT, that is P probability, okay, the probability that the system is in state K at time T. Okay, so let PKT, the probability that the system is in state K at time T, that is server or BC at time T. Okay, del K, call arrival rate in state K. Already we have explained the parameter of telecom traffic about the del. Mu k, that is call termination rate in state k. Okay, then we have following probabilities in the time interval delta. So these are the things which we assume, and then we are having the following probabilities in time interval delta, that is p exactly one arrival, that is probability exactly one arrival. This is that is del into delta, lambda is into delta, that is the one arrival. P, that is exactly probability, exactly one termination, that is mu delta. Okay, only one. Then no arrival, when there will be no arrival, that is 1 minus del lambda del t, no termination, 1 minus mu delta t. So these are the simple things which you should understand, because we are going to use these equations in the coming slides. Probability of finding the system is state k at time t plus delta t is given by. So we assume this condition, that is we assume condition at time t. Now if you want to find out the probability at time t plus delta t, or that is we are going to insert pk t plus delta t. So what will happen? Then pk minus 1 t, that is probability, earlier probability, k lambda k minus 1 delta t, that is the call arrival, this is called termination, just identified the arrival and termination with the help of these terms. Okay, then these are the no arrival and no termination probability. Okay, so these all terms, these terms and these terms, this is the probability of call arrival at t plus delta t. This is a call termination, probability of call termination. This is no arrival, no termination. Probability of no arrival, no termination. So this equation is we can write as it. The first red term, this term represent the possibilities of finding the system in state k minus 1 at time t. Okay. And a birth or call request occurring during the time interval t plus t. Okay, so these terms may be considered or has the probability in state k minus 1 at time t, and a birth or call request occurring during the time interval t plus delta t. The second term, that is this term, green, represent the possibility of finding the system in state k plus 1 at time t, and when we are having k plus 1, then a death or call termination occurring during the time interval t plus delta t. Okay, now there are two times, t and t plus. The last term below represent no arrival, no termination. As I have explained, this is no arrival, no termination probability of calls. Expanding the above equation and ignoring the second order we have. So expanding the above equations, we have this reduce pk t plus delta t equations, which we gave the, this equation, we are giving equation number 1, and we are naming this equation as 2. To determine the dynamic of system, which is given by the rate of change of probability pk with time, because we are finding the dynamic system of telecom traffic, so pk must be changed with the time. Okay, rearranging the terms in above equation we have, and this one with respect to delta t, that is we are rearranging and just coming the delta t into this one under this delta t, and this equation is equation number 3. In the limit, if delta t approaches to 0, we get this equation dpkt upon d, and this one, this equation 4, which is the differential equation governing the dynamic of a BT process. Okay, so this is the differential equation which denotes governing the dynamic of a BD process. Okay, so guys, it was all about the dynamic equation of BD process. For k is equal to 0, that is no call in progress, there can be no termination of call. If there is no call in progress, then obviously there will be no termination, that is mu naught will be 0. Further, there can be no state with minus 1 as the state, therefore k is equal to 0. That is dp naught, we are just assuming dp k is equal to 0. dp t naught t upon dt. p1 t2, just putting all values and in the previous equations, and you get this is the equation 5, which gives the rate of change of state of probabilities. Okay, so this is the probability of rate of change of state possibilities. steady state condition. Now this was the dynamic. Now what about the state steady state? The state possibilities reach an equilibrium value and don't change with time. That is when we pkt1 and pkt2 will be equal to, and pkti or pk is equal to, that all value will be zero, then there will be no change. For example, when commercial offices start functioning around 10 a.m., switching network pick up traffic and reach a steady state condition. When the state possibility is stabilizing, that condition we have dp naught up t upon dt is equal to zero. Okay, so it rises from 10 to and reaches as maximum 12, and it becomes a steady state. Okay, then the BD process become stationary. Therefore, the steady state equation of a BD process are, so it will be equal to zero. That is all. That is, we are putting dTP naught upon dt is equal to zero. Okay, for k greater than one. Then after solving this one, we are having this value equation. Steady state behavior of a telecom switching system is governed by equation 5 and 6 when the system is modeled as a BC process. So the equation 5 and 6 govern the steady state equation or behavior of telecom switching. So in this one, in this lecture, so we just saw the dynamic probabilities or possibilities of call arrival termination and steady state condition of telecom traffic. So you need to have extra attention on this one by just solving all equations, and these are simples, very simples. When you will go through it, then you will find it easy. Okay, so it was all about BD process analysis. Thank you very much.